Hi guys, it's McKenna, and today I want to talk about the books that I gave for Christmas. So this year I had the wonderful opportunity to give three people in my life that I love dearly books for Christmas. Two of these were family members, and one was an old teacher that I still love to this day. And this video is pretty much going to be me talking about the books that I gifted these people and why I specifically chose that book to gift to them. And my cat is going to be in this video, because he wants to be. So the first book is a book I gave my sister-in-law. I haven't actually given it to her yet. This is the only one that I haven't yet given, and I'm going to be able to give it to her tomorrow or the day after that. I'm filming this on actual Christmas Day. But the thing that I got her, I made her a nice book sleeve with Disney print all over it, and she loves Disney, and her favorite Disney movie is The Little Mermaid, so I got her Part of Your World, A Twisted Tale by Liz Braswell. I thought she would like this book because she loves Disney, and her favorite Disney movie is The Little Mermaid, so I got her the Twisted Tale to it. I don't really have any other rhyme or reason for choosing this specific book because I don't know her specific book taste, and I thought this would just be a nice thing that she would enjoy. The next book I gave was to my other sister-in-law, and it was Undead Girl Gang by Lily Anderson. I asked this specific sister-in-law if she would be open to me giving her a book that I liked for Christmas, and she said yes. So I cross-referenced things of books that I would be okay with her knowing that I read and my brother knowing that I read. God, that sounds so bad. Cross-referencing that with a book that I thought was easy to get into and that was kind of short that she would be able to get through because she's not much of a reader but she wants to get more into it. I ended up going with Undead Girl Gang because I think that the narration is great, the pacing of the story is great, and although it wasn't like my favorite book in the world, I really enjoyed it. And she said that they had the blurbs of Hocus Pocus and Mean Girls, which are movies that she really likes, so I was super glad about that. And the final book I gave for Christmas was to my old history teacher, and I gave him a book on the history of string. When he was my teacher back my sophomore year of high school, he had this book that he recommended to me, which I now have. I haven't yet read, but it is The History of Salt. He went on to do a short, like, talking about the book and how it talks about how salt affects our everyday life, even though that's not something that we would really think of, or that salt isn't something we really think about needing every day when it has affected and impacted our lives so much, which I thought was really interesting enough obviously to go out and buy the book. And after this he mentioned that he really likes the history of small things, which just means, like, you know, small things that you don't think about in life. He loves to learn the history of them. And my mom had previously bought this book at a discount store for my dad, and my dad didn't really want it, so I said, can I give this to my history teacher because I think he'd love it. And he was so excited about it when I gave it to him. And those are all the books that I gave for Christmas. Let me know what books you gave for Christmas, what books you got for Christmas, all of those juicy deets down in the comments below. Make sure to also like and subscribe, and I will see you sometime for a new one. Bye!